I'm an old town slugger. Why after why we ain't never got a sub, made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Stunned like no one stunned. She came back then, came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour, Chris Tucker. You can never stay me for another. I had to wait my time like a buffer. I'm that did I stutter to stutter. Ball hard, might get a tick. Bought a push start for it, got a check.
Downtown between Brush Street and I-375. That's where we're located in the heart of Detroit at Ford Field, which first opened back in 2002. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Cincinnati Bengals. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. For the first time with DeAndre Swift. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Now this defense for the Bengals, they played extremely well last week in that win over Green Bay.
Yeah, what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down and they're playing with extreme confidence.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Back to throw. Gone. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. The tight end, Hockenson. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a play fake, and it's gone. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1?
3rd and 7.
Now it's Goff off the bootleg. My rifle's one, that's going to be intercepted. Picked off around the 41, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Well, it's no secret, he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Back to Mixon on second down. And he's got some space here. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score.
Boy, I tell you what, when you get a running back who can move like that in the open field, that's something to take advantage of, and they certainly did there. Evan McPherson now for the PAT.
And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals.
Makes the score Bengals 7, Lions nothing. Evan McPherson to kick off for Cincinnati.
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Goff now looking to throw. Deep ball for Goodwin. And it is caught at the 10-yard line. And they're going to have those way down in Cincinnati territory. A big play there for Detroit.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Play action. It's gone. He'll buy some time right. Looking for Hockenson, and he's got it. Touchdown, Detroit. T.J. Hockenson, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Brandon Wilson now from his end zone. The Bengals drive about to get going. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Back to Mixon on 2nd down.
And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10.
Burrow going to give this to Mixon.
And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
That was well played there defensively. 2 tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end, and he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a 1st down. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 46. Now it's Burrow. Flushed out right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's 2nd down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive game.
On 2nd down, here's Mixon. And a pretty good run as he'll get this down close to a 1st at the Lions 38. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. Burrow looking to pass. Flush to his right.
Well, he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
That's something you have to be aware of as a defense and have to find a way to account for him. And if you're not going to use a spy, you're telling your guys to keep your eyes on him, because when he breaks out and makes plays like that, all he does is hurt you.
Have to at least be able to contain him somewhat. There they could not. Mixon with a first down carry. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. And now they will throw it with Burrow. Man open his board. It's complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 15-yard line.
And time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
Ball sits on the 10, second and 5. Running left, it's Mixon. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Mixon. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the 4-yard line. From back at the 4, here's second and goal. A handoff running left, Mixon. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice.
And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Joe Mixon with his 13th touchdown of the year and 2nd of the game. And the Bengals have taken the lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quick.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The Clemson product, DJ Reader, got in for the sack.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up 4 last week, didn't they?
Yes, and just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
From the gun, here's Goff. He'll get this off to Swift. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a 1st and 10 at the 46. Goff throwing complete for Swift. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds.
And a fresh start for DeAndre Swift and his teammates with this brand new coaching staff. And they believe he can be a 3-down back. They want to get him in space against linebackers. 46 catches his rookie year. They expect that number to get into the 60s.
On 1st and 10, it's Swift. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Throwing on 3rd, Goff.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
So the margin shrinks there as they get the field goal to draw them a bit closer here in the second quarter.
Yeah, nice snap, nice hold. They just want to keep this game close, so give them credit for finishing that one off with three.
And Wilson is perfectly content to bring this out to the 25, a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
From the 31, Burrow. Escaping the pressure right. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
Offensively, they like their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
They'll run on first down. Mixon, and this winds up a gain of four to the 41. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll try the left side. Mixon, and he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down at four now. Now Burrow. Open man, it's complete to Higgins. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. Seventh play of the drive, fourth coming on third and eight. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Fourth down. Here's Joe Burrow. He rifles one. It's intercepted. Picked off by Darquez Dennard. And the Lions are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Gone. That's into the hands of Khalif Raymond. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. On first down, Swift. Jesse Bates made the tackle from his safety spot. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Eluding the pressure right. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Off play action. Here's Goff. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
Certainly looked like maybe his third or his fourth read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Austin Seibert on for the field goal.
And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there.
That kick, by the way, Charles, a career long.
Well, we did watch him in pregame, and he hit from this distance, so not a surprise. But there's still something exciting about it, carrying it over from practice and pregame to actually doing it in live action.
It's a squib kick fielded just inside the 20. So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Bengals set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number three. About to get going, and they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he's going to be stopped short of a first down as they'll get to him at about the 33. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
Here we go. Big 13. Big 13. And you got to go score.
They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. To the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, the line judge says they're in. That'll be a first down.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. So first and 10 now from the 30.
And how about the rapport that these two had last year as rookies? Exactly what the Bengals had in mind when they made Joe Burrow the first-round pick and T. Higgins the second.
And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Back to Mixon on second down. Gets past one man, and they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Here's a give to Mixon. This carry, despite the extra effort, will be stopped short of the 10. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. On third down, Mixon, and he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Joe Mixon, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is up to 8.
Bengals 21, Lions 13. Evan McPherson to kick off for Cincinnati.
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12.
Here's Goff. Flushed out right. He put it on the carpet, a fumble. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Here's Goff. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and 9, Burrow. Open man is Uzama. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Burrow on play action. They'll roll him out right. That is caught. It's Uzama. And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. The tackle made by L.J. Ford.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
Back to Mixon on second down. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11.
Taken down at the 11-yard line. It's a gain-yard. And it's third down.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Bengals on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 7. Here's Burrow. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defense. And he is in. Touchdown, Bengals. Joe Mixon. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Bengals are looking to run it to 5-1 on the season as they add to their fourth quarter lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is up to 15 now. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away.
Good catch made at the 25-yard line. The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Deep ball for Goodwin.
And yet again, Goff is intercepted.
Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes.
And the Bengals are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. And that pretty much has been the storyline, Charles. This defense, they seem to be one step ahead from the start of the game until now.
And you identified it perfectly, and we can see the frustration that's settling in now. And it's probably been there for a long time, but now it's evident because you can see it in their faces, you can see it in their body language, maybe even a little bit in that play call that ended up.
Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score.
Ja'Marr Chase,
his third touchdown now on the year.
And the Bengals add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Extra point by McPherson, up and good.
And the lead opens up now to 22 points.
Lions 13.
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one.
Out of bounds at the 32-yard line. It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Goff.
They'll try and set up the screen to Swift.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Flush to his right.
He'll drop this one off to Swift.
3 yards the gain there, 2nd down. Again, Goff.
He'll find Swift out of the backfield.
And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. Out of the gun, Goff. Right side, it's the tight end, Hockenson. 7 yards, the pickup there.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3 at the 25-yard line.
From the 25 on 2nd down, Goff.
And that's out to the flat for Swift.
And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19.
A gain of 6. That's another Detroit Lions.
From the red zone now, Goff.
He'll get this into the hands of Swift once again.
And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive.
Working with a 2nd and 3.
Play action. It's Goff. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Ricardo Allen with a pick.
Come on now. Come on.
And it's a huge return as he brings this all the way back down to the 15-yard line.
Well, that's the danger of throwing the ball to that part of the field, because if it does get picked off, as we just saw there, they can run a long way. They're actually fortunate they didn't give up a touchdown in addition.
They'll run on 1st down. Mixon. They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run.
1 yard gain brings up 2nd and 9.
Off the play fake. Here's Burrow. Sideline throw. It's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll make it 3rd and 1.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. He lost two, and it brings up fourth. Touchdown, Bengals. That's caught. Ja'Marr Chase with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Bengals use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now.
Evan McPherson.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
First down.
Throwing again is gone. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete. What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that one. He's fortunate it was just incomplete and not intercepted.
Meanwhile, Goff's throw complete there to St. Brown. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 41-yard line. A shotgun snap for Goff. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And the Bengals are going to take over here up near the 40. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get it.
Man, it's caught at the 6-yard line, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and that will extend this big lead.
Lions
13. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away.
Made at the 25-yard line. The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss. Escaping the pressure right. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard.
Brings up second and a yard.
Goff now looks to throw. He's going to let it fly. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown. But they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
I love watching Goodwin play. Of course, everybody knows the story of him being an Olympian. He's a long jumper,
yes,
right?
Yes.
But you know that he has that athleticism, that big playability.
He certainly does. And not only was he an Olympian as a long jumper, married to a sprinter. How about that for speed in one family? And I love his end zone celebrations now. When he does go deep and beat someone for a touchdown, now he does the long jump as his celebration. Pretty cool deal.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. No return here for Wilson. It's a touchback. It'll come out to the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. And this one has gone pretty well to form. They've come in, had little problem thus far, and now they'll try to polish things off in the fourth. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. Again, it's Mixon. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now it looks like he'll throw here, eluding the pressure right. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crack.
And under the Lions pressure, he's brought down. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining.
Well, here's where having mobility sometimes can work against you as a quarterback. He thinks he can retreat and outrun the pressure. But that time, they zeroed in on him and took him down for a big loss, partner.
A really big loss. So that'll leave Burrow and the Bengals with a third and long after that sack we just saw. Sliding out of the pocket. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Bengals, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Baltimore to take on the Ravens. Meanwhile, for the Lions, the losses are piling up as they drop to 1-5 now. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to L.A. to take on the Rams.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chiller, click full of diamonds like Thriller. Got real, about to get real.
I'm positive. was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claiming you my dog and then you hold on me? Nowadays, they ain't showing real loyalty. I was walking down the dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember, we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. Touchdown.